thought I had it all together, but I was led astray.
Oh, I didn't see you there. Kale, can we see your matches? Welcome to Chemical Reactions. Okay. Chemical Reactions. So now, guys, there's a lot of other chemical reactions we can do, but one of the most classical ones is mixing Coca-Cola. Now, obviously, having all these chemical experiments, we always have to be safe. In this case, but since there's other people in the vicinity, hence the name Caleb, I've got one for him too! Always be safe, Caleb. So, now when we're taking these, what you have to do, so we're gonna put this aside, and we're gonna take this right here. And, oh, always gotta remember, be safe. So what you're gonna do, you're gonna open this, right? It's gonna fit, Okay, yeah. Anyways, so you're gonna open it. Take one Minto. And apparently, I've heard that's when you do these things, it like fizzes up, but I don't think it should. So we're gonna go big or go home. But first, I'm gonna take four Mintos. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, vaminos! Look at this thing go! Chemical reactions!
And so after we just watched that semi-entertaining experiment with Andrew, now it's time to get to the science behind it for the first time. Coca-Mentos. Coca-Mentos is what is called a physical change, which I can tell if it's a physical reaction. Is it reversible no matter how hard it is? Even if it means complete. Even if it means trying to find a needle in a haystack, it can still be found. For example, salt and water. It's a complete change because of the fact that you can boil the water to get the salt. And if it's also a physical reaction, color change, bubbles, or if there's any precipitation, for example, smoke, steam, or fog, that is going off. For example, putting watercolor in water, it's color change, so which means it's still water, just with color, with coloring in it, along with boiling water. Has bubbles and precipitation, making it even more obvious of it being a physical reaction. Is it the same products? So if I put, I'm going to use salt and water as an example, if I take salt and water and I combine those, do I still have salt and water when I deconstruct it or when it's as salt water? Does the reactant produce another substance? So chemical reactions work as they take two or more elements, combine them, and then make something new out of it that was not there before. Physical reactions just add on to it. They don't change it into something new. And it doesn't change from a liquid or to gas. As long as there's a change in state. So for example, water being frozen turns to ice. Melted, turns into gas. Okay, and I believe that's all that I have for you right now, so let us move on to another experiment.
Alright, thanks Caleb. On to our next reaction, fireworks. Anyways. Alright guys, our next experiment is going to be fireworks. So, this is a combustion reaction. So, in my pocket, I have two. I only need one though. So I got one. So now, we're going to be talking about how sparklers and different sort of like chemicals in here cause a chemical reaction. So I got some matches right here. And in my pocket, my other pocket, I got a match. So I'm not going to make that weird mistake last time. No, indeed. Ready? Oh, and it's going. It's going. Oh my gosh. This is why you don't like fireworks. And it's... Let's do another one. Oh my gosh. This is like trying to... Alright, we got three this time. Should work. Why isn't it not working? You know what? This is why we cannot do things. Let's do it again. And it goes out again. Hold up. I'm gonna relight this thing again so we can get it. So. Would you mind holding these, Christian? Thank you, buddy.
Yeah.
All right. No. We're gonna. Oh. Just a thing again. All right. I was gonna say something, but this is a chemical reaction. I don't ever listen to me because I'm not safe. Look at that. Not being safe. So you always look. You see how there's different? It's changing colors. When it's changing colors, there's certain different chemicals that are happening in this. So. I don't know. This is just a chemical reaction.
We're back after that interesting experiment with the fireworks. We're now going to move on to the science about it, starting off with combustion. So combustion, long story short, is the process of burning something. That's the entire definition. Shortened, but... it is pretty much the process of being destroyed or burned. And it's the first chemical change that we noticed. And combustion is understood quite well because of the oxidation. And oxidation is any reaction which includes oxygen. For example, fire. It uses all the once the fire is started, it would stop if there was no more oxygen. And the history behind combustion, the first scientific attempt to explain it was done by a Flemish physician by the name of Johannes Baptiste von Helmont. And Helmont thought that combustion was a wild spirit, as he put it, that was escaping from whatever was being destroyed. And so, after that, we'll be back a little bit later after we go watch Andrew and Oscar with another movie.
Our experiment number three is baking soda and vinegar. So, according to my calculations, we don't need this calculator. So now, what we're gonna do, we're gonna put in, 1.5 centimeters of...
Andrew, it's milliliters.
1.5 milliliters.
150.
150 milliliters of vinegar in. So you see, 150 milliliters. I know it's not really that steady, but it's good enough. So then what we have to do, you gotta make sure you're sanitary. Now what we're gonna be doing, we're gonna be taking baking soda, right? Good Arm & Hammer, the standard of purity. So now what we're gonna do, we're gonna take, I don't know, this much baking soda, and we're just gonna slightly pour it into there. See that fizzing? That is a example of chemical reaction. Certain chemicals in the vinegar react with the chemicals in the baking soda, which causes it to rise up, creating a chemical reaction. Now see, if we do right here, you can see that the bubbles are consuming about, I don't know, maybe 1/10 of the graduated cylinder. And as it
slows,
9/10, my bad, and slowly increasing, you can see as the bubbles are going down, it is replacing it with vinegar, which is now a mixed with baking soda. So,
okay, we're back. This is probably gonna be the last time you see me, so goodbye. But before we go, we got one more thing, and it's of balancing equations. Balancing equations are pretty simple once you know how to do it and you had enough practice. The reason you do it is so then they follow the for a law of conservation of mass, which it says that mass cannot be gained, cannot be lost or gained. It can just be changed. How you do it? This is pretty simple. I broke it down into 3 steps for you. Step 1 is just to change the number in front of the compound or molecule, so that the number of atoms of the element is the same on each side of the equation. Step 2, check number of molecules to make sure that they'll balance. For sometimes when you change one coefficient, it will change what the rest of the equation is, which means you'll have to keep on going and going until you figure it out. It's step 3, which is repeat steps 1 and 2 until all molecules on either side of the equation are balanced. Sometimes that means you just need to put a couple of coefficients, or it means you have to go through many, many times. It has to be written on the lowest common denominator. So the lowest common denominator is 2. You can't put 10 just because that was the first number you found it. It has to be the lowest, so which means you might have to go back to tracking and figure out if it can be smaller. And that's all I got, so I'll be seeing you around.